Now we have reached on the last section of this second part lecture. And in this, I will show you a lot of images about everything here. And then we'll see, we'll just get into details so you will understand better. When we use the images, it becomes clearer. But I just listed some of the, you know, some of the names, the symbols, or, you know, deities. You know, everyone knows the nine muses, right? Even 소녀시대. Funny, I left. I don't know, Girls' Generation, they call, right? That's how they known in the Western world. They are made of nine girls. Anyhow, nine muses here. That's in Greek, in that European context. Nine matrikas, this is from India. And matrikas means nine mothers. These are the images we will see. Oh, and nine-headed Kwan Im, we saw that, right? The Kwan Im that has nine heads. And yuga dressel, we've seen this one. This is still like a Shindansu, the tree of life, or the Koma's tree, Ungyo's tree. That also is depicted with the nine words. And you will see mandalas. You know mandalas? It's a diagram that depicts the way it is, the things, how things are manifested. And that's and flower life and egg of life. Western people, somehow, they are very good in naming. They name. Whereas we have this one, we don't have the name. Because we have forgotten this tradition, at least in our time. Well, so here that I have images and symbols of nine numerology or saved in one folder, so we are going to see them. And remember that this tree, the flower of life, in the video we just saw, right? These eight poles, they're put together, right? And that's what it is. That's what it is. And they are the embodiment, the very basic structure of life, the very first, the core of life. And that, in English, people have named the flower of life. It's interesting. I didn't know that was called the flower of life. Now, when it's in a two-dimensional space, it's called the flower of life. When they use three-dimensional, and there is another name, which is the egg of life. Do you see that one on the right side? That's eight poles. Can you tell they are eight poles? Do you? Do you see eight poles? So just remember, eight daughters of Mago Tria, Mago Samshins. Mago Hermes had eight daughters. Right? That's what this is about. And this is how the cells divide itself. Well, in the first cell, well, this is a different image from two. One divides in two, it becomes four and eight. And that's the pattern that is included. And this is, I cannot see the name of this one, but this is one of the figures. It's goddess figures. I think this could be from Tibet or South China somewhere. You see eight arms, right? Do you see eight arms? And then, interestingly, it should be three heads, you know, because this one, it's possible that they lost the meaning of these three heads. So it could be they made four heads. You know why they made, I think in my thinking, they had to create this, they thought maybe they should have four heads. You know why? Because the arms, eight arms, then you need eight heads. Well, that's so anyhow, this has four heads, but in other more like, you know, figurines from Europe, right? They have three heads more. And this is the same, eight arms. We will get to the image of Durga's, you know, a lot of similar. Well, this eight trigrams, right? We said the palge. And this is all about this one. This looks really complicated, really high level, whatever discussion. It is, but basically this is about it. This 팔괘 came from this. These are the same thing. And this is Medusa from you know, from the Western mythology. But Medusa has nine snakes on her head. This is not really that clear, but I have other images. And this is nine matrikas from India, ancient Hinduism. They say Hinduism, but you know, we need to really clarify what Hinduism is. Because it's not the what these cultural manifestations say something different from what Hindu philosophy or even religion. And sometimes it can be nine, sometimes it can be eight. So, and you know this is nine muses, right? This image and nine. And this is another form of matrikas. It's not eight matrikas. It's like palsanyo. Eight sonyas in Korean tradition. I forgot, it could be Durga? Yeah, Durga. I have a lot of Durga images you will see. And Durga is one of the great goddess, like equivalent to Mago in Hinduism. Let's call it Hinduism. We don't have other languages. So you know, when we talk about this pre-patriarchal divine, we don't have languages. It's very difficult. When we use that language, then people associate with that. Oh, that one. But in patriarchy, no, that's not the one. So anyhow, this is Durga image. And relatively recently, that someone informed in Thailand. Thailand has a lot of images. I forgot the name of it. Even modern king, you know, of Thailand, that he is rebuilding these images. I forgot. And eight arms. It's just like Durga, a mixture of everything. But it's very, very prevalent. You will see a lot of them. And this is one of the simple mandalas. This is called mandalas. We have a word for this one, right, in Korean. Mandalas, and then you see eight petals, right? Eight petals. And this is another Durga, venerated in India. And usually she has this spear, right? You see the spear, and what does she do? She just kills this patriarchal man, hero. So this is like the other way of patriarchal hero killing the eight-headed snake. This is much older. So we can tell there was, in the past, there is a conflict, a war of the sex between sexes. And then the iconography reflects. And this is Medusa from the West. And we get into another modern depiction of Durga. And Kali, the fierce goddess, is one of her nine manifestations. This should be eight. This has nine, and anyhow, so what it means is just this one. It could sometimes nine, sometimes eight. But we know what that means already. And Durga comes with eight bells, right? And another Durga, a lot of Durgas. It's just which too obvious. It's too pervasive. And then always Durga kills this patriarchal hero. Okay, my lecture is up to here. And thank you very much.